medical and laser application. Yeah, my career is the Dean of Faculty of Science from 2017-29, and also Education and Culture Attaché in Germany, and head of the delegation of Frankfurt Book Fair in Germany. So we are I'm professor in medical physics. Yeah. So I in the beginning I say that smile. Yeah. Because smile is sodako. If you go in the broad, for example, yeah. For example, I live in Germany for 12 years in Germany. However, is the Germany is the people is very earned, but we try to always smile. Now, the outline of my topic is there are four topics. The meaning of ukwa, types of ukwa, and also the benefit of ukwa. And the last, the implementation of ukwa. Yeah, so why is ukwa is very important? Yeah, I have also experience, yeah, in as I was a student in Paderborn University, I also do my ukwa. Yeah, the ukwa is the soul of bond that foster the deep feeling of affection, yeah, love, and deep respect for everyone, where the affinity of soul is linked by bond of similarity, such as similarity in lineage. Yeah, lineage is mean is nasab. Lineage is in the descendants. Similarity in religion, nationality, and also in fellow human being. Yeah, the important thing is ukwa is brotherhood. Yeah, if I say normally I live in Germany for 12 years, I join also with the brotherhood. Yeah, in Germany we call Brüderlichkeit. Yeah, brotherhood among Muslim. Yeah, will foster to deep sense of the affection in the soul of every Muslim and bring positive impact. So this why in the beginning I say smile. Yeah, because smile is a sodako. Yeah, this is very important. Smile is sodako. Smile is sodako. So the soul to bring always positive impact. Yeah, such as helping each other and prioritizing others. Yeah, prioritizing others, respecting each other, being friendly and easy to forgive each other. Yeah. So if we see the ukwa is soul bond. Yeah, the soul bond. Kalau bahasa Indonesianya itu ikatan jiwa. Yeah, the soul bond. So you see, if we have a good brotherhood, not only among Muslim, yeah, but we are also in nationality, in humanity. For example, we living in the world, yeah. Hello, if you see, we are the world, we are the children, gitu kan? If you see in the one of the popular song in the planet, in I think in 1990, yeah, 1990. So with the soul of one, yeah, we can the affection, yeah, we can affection each other's love and also respect. But we have a similarity in not only in religion, not only in nasab, yeah, in nasab is mean is lineage. Yeah, but also in nationality, but the ukwa, the broader is humanity. For example, in if you go to the Europe, yeah, there are many people not come from Indonesia. Yeah, I give the example as I a student in the University of Paderborn. Yeah, it called in Germany is Universität Fachhochschule Paderborn. Yeah, so I have a lot of friends. Yeah, it's come from India, He come from Chinese, he come from Tunisian, he come from Egypt, he come from Bosnia Herzegovina, he come from Syria. So there are a humanity. We not call it nationality as Indonesia. Yeah, the important thing from the ukhuwah is affection. Yeah, kasih sayang, love, cinta, and respect, penghormatan, and also with the impact with the ukhuwah is mutual help. Yeah, saling tolong menolong, mutual respect. Yeah, saling menghargai, put other first. Yeah, itu mengutamakan orang lain and ramah. Yeah, the important thing is here in ramah. Yeah, you see that from the in actually, yeah, Indonesia in the foreign people, we see Indonesia is very popular as friendly. Yeah, so this why we should build our ukhuwah, yeah, is as a soul bond, yeah, ikatan jiwa. Yeah. Now so there are several type of ukhuwah, yeah, the several type of ukhuwah. So we can see here this is ukhuwah Islamia, ukhuwah Watonia, ukhuwah Bahsaria. Yeah. Islamia we are a brotherhood in religion, we are Watonia brotherhood in country. It means, for example, in Indonesia, we are very lucky. Indonesia, if have there are many ethnic group, yeah, about 300 more from 300 ethnic group from several island. For example, I come from Surabaya. I am is Javanese. Maybe Mbak Salsabila, Mbak Salsabila, where are you come from, Mbak Salsabila?
Surabaya.
Oh, it's also Surabaya itu ya. Okay, now I ask the others student. Yeah, Mbak Yasmin, where are you come from, Mbak Yasmin? Mbak Yasmin? Yasmin Nur Heisa, Helisa ya. Where are you come from, Mbak?
From Surabaya, sir.
Oh, Surabaya also.
Yes, no, sir.
Mbak Raisa Arum. Mbak Raisa Arum, where are you come from?
From Bandung, sir.
From Bandung. Are you Sundanese, Mbak Raisa?
No, both of my parents from Java, sir.
Oh, from Java. Mas Farel, Muhammad, where are you come from, Mas Farel?
I'm from Kalimantan, sir.
Oh, Kalimantan. Are you Malaya? Actually, your parent is, do you speak Malaya, ya? Yeah? Malay in Kalimantan, is correct?
No, sir. Dayak.
Oh, Dayak. Oh, yeah, yeah. Could you please say in Dayak, Mas?
Selamat. I'm not very good.
Oh, no, no. Only good night. What is good night in Dayak?
Is this, I think
similar.
Where like, I came from, I think still the same, sir.
Oh,
selamat okay. Malam,
oh, selamat malam.
It's not really thick.
Oh, it's not really. Okay, I would like to say somebody who come from can speak Sundanese. How to say selamat malam in Sundanese? Okay, I close my presentation. I would like to see where come from Lombok. Do you come from Lombok? Sasak? Sundanese? Bangka? Belitung? Riau? Mas Hamas? Hamas Rabani, where are you come from, Mas Hamas?
Banyuwangi, sir.
Ah, okay, Banyuwangi. Speak in Osing, Mas Hamas.
Saya orang Banyuwangi, bahasa usingnya isun lare using.
Apa please repeat again?
Isun lare using.
Ismun.
Isun.
Oh, ismun lare using.
Isun, Mbak. I S U N.
Isun. Oh, insun ya.
Iya, yang kayak lagu-lagu biasa, Mbak. Isun.
Oh, insun lare using. Insun ya. Lari Banyuwangi gitu ya. Oh, nice. Thank you Mas Amas.
Yes, sir.
It's very nice. Mas Brian Adam, where are you come from, Mas Brian?
I'm from Pasuruan, sir.
Okay, speak with Maduranis, Mas.
I cannot speak Madura.
Who cannot speak? Because yeah. The people from Pasuruan, you most often speak in Maduranis, ya? Yeah?
Yes, almost from Pasuruan speak Madura.
Okay. Thank you. Mbak Raisa Regina, where are you come from, Mbak Raisa? Mbak Raisa
from
Regina.
From Jakarta, sir.
Oh, from Jakarta. Please speak in Betawi, Mbak.
I live in Jakarta, but my parents are from Jogja.
I see. Okay, thank you. So, thank you, Mbak Regina. Now we come to my talk again. Yeah, we are very, very like lucky in Indonesia. Yeah, in our country, we have a philosophy united in diversity. There are the people come from Lombok, come from Sasak, yeah, and when they speak in Sasak and also in Papua, is especially in Papua, there are many languages there, about more than 200, yeah, in Papua. Yeah, I have a lot of experience as I was in Papua. And also, if we go to the Kalimantan, for example, is some from Dayak, yeah, and also from the others ethnic group, yeah. So, but however, we are is brotherhood, yeah. Is one not only is countrymen is sometime is not one some same religion, but from the Christian, from the Catholic, and also from Hindu, Buddha. That is ukhuwah watonia, yeah. And also the Basaria is fellow human. Yeah, like fellow human, Basaria. For example, if you go to the Turkey, yeah, 2 months ago I went to the Turkey because of joined with the Technofest in the Turkey. So most of the people speak in the Turkey. Yeah, they cannot speak in English, and also he cannot speak in Germany. He cannot speak in France. But most of them speak in the Turkey. So, but however, he is also our brother, yeah, our friend. Yeah, we call this is Ukhuwah Basaria, yeah, Ukhuwah Basaria. So that is the type of Ukhuwah, yeah. The type of Ukhuwah is broader, yeah, sangat luas sekali. Is broader, not only. Tidak hanya satu agama, satu negara, tidak hanya Basaria itu seluruh dunia ya, tetapi semuanya adalah saudara, gitu ya. Jadi ini penting yang harus diperhatikan. So if we see ya in the Al-Qur'an surat Al-Hujurat ayat 10 ya, a'udzubillahi minasyaitonirrajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Innamal mu'minuna ikhwata. Fa aslihu baina akhawa waikum wattaqullaha la'allakum turhamun. Shadaqallahul adzim. Artinya orang-orang beriman itu sesungguhnya bersaudara, ya. Sebab itu damaikanlah, perbaikilah hubungan antara kedua saudara itu, dan takutlah kepada Allah supaya kamu mendapat rahmat. So that's mean ya, yeah, we are brotherhood, ya. Yeah. So here is from the tafsir from Kementerian Agama, it's better in bahasa, yeah, because you are very clear to understand. Actually, in the in Surat Al-Hujarat 10, this is very important, that in the same religion, we are is brotherhood. Yeah, we cannot, however, one is from the other community, but all of us is brother, yeah, brotherhood. And also here in the hadith, yeah, yang in riwayat Muslim dan Abu Darda, ya, apabila seorang Muslim mendoakan saudaranya yang gaib, maka malaikat berkata, amin, ya, dan semoga kamu pun mendapat seperti itu. So that was important is praying for a Muslim, ya, yeah, for the our brother, ya, yeah, is a die. So the important thing is also Allah is hear our doa, ya. Yeah. So it's very important. And also with the brotherhood, ya, yeah, karena persaudaraan itu mendorong ke arah perdamaian. Ya, yeah, that means the brotherhood built in the peaceful, ya. Yeah. So Allah suggest us, ya, yeah, to peaceful between us. Gitu ya. This is very important. This is ukhuwa Islamia. That and also our prophet say, ya, yeah, a mu'min is a brother the other mu'min. Ya, yeah, it's like a build. Ya, yeah, seperti laksana bangunan yang build each other, saling menguatkan satu sama yang lain. Ya, yeah, kaum mu'minin itu seperti satu anggota keluarga. Ya, yeah, jadi kalau ada yang sakit, ya merasa sakit, ya. And also Nabi bersabda bahwa perumpamaan kaum mukmin in the love, ya, yeah, and also the affection is like a body, ya. Yeah. If one is sick, the others feel also not comfortable. Jadi kalau ada yang satunya sakit, yang satunya juga merasakan sakit. Ini adalah di hadis riwayat Bukhari Muslim, ya, and Muslim. Nah, now we see, I call you already, not only ukhuwah Islamia, but also ukhuwah Watonia. Ya, ukhuwah Watonia is ukhuwah in, like in our country. We have, for example, in Al-Baqarah Surat Al-Ma'idah, ya, is the meaning is dan kami telah menurunkan kitab Al-Qur'an kepada Muhammad dengan membawa kebenaran yang membenarkan kitab-kitab yang diturunkan sebelumnya, ya, dan menjaganya, maka putuskanlah perkara mereka menurut apa yang diturunkan Allah dan janganlah engkau mengikuti keinginan mereka dengan meninggalkan kebenaran yang telah datang kepadamu untuk setiap umat di antara kamu, ya, kami berikan aturan dan jalan yang terang. Kalau Allah menghendaki, niscaya kamu dijadikannya satu umat saja. Tetapi Allah hendak menguji kamu terhadap karunia yang telah diberikannya kepadanya. Maka berlomba-lombalah berbuat kebajikan. So, it's sunnatullah, ya, in our country, we are consist of several ethnic. I explained before. For example, there is a Sundanese, Javanese, and Sasakis, yeah, and Balinese, and also Dayakis, and also Papuanese, Molukunese, yeah, and also several ethnic of group, and also every ethnic also have every religion. We are different. Sometimes is Catholic, sometimes is Hindu. Sometimes Protestant, ya, yeah, but we are is ukhuwah Watonia, ya, yeah, we are is brother, ya. Yeah. However, is not a Muslim, but he is brother. It's like in the Madinah, Piagam Madinah, ya. Yeah. And you see in the Piagam Madinah, there are many religion in Madinah, ya. Yeah. In the Madinah, there is Juden. And also mu'minin, and also there are many group in Madinah, yeah, in the Madinah state in 25 pasal 25, and also in the Madinah state in 37, yeah. Bagi kaum Yahudi ada kewajiban biaya dan bagi kaum Muslimin ada kewajiban biaya. Jadi in the Madinah not only Muslim but also there are Juden and also Majusi also there. So that's mean in this situation, yeah, Ukhuwah Watoniyah not only a Muslim, yeah, Muslim with the other religions. And also Kiai Hasyim Asy'ari in 1871 and 1947, yeah, he say is hubul watan minal iman, yeah, love in our country is part of our freedom, yeah, jadi kebagian daripada iman itu. And also Kiai Abdullah Hasan Asbullah from 1888 until 1971, yeah, Ukhuwah Islamiyah, yeah, is perfectly integrated, is love in our country. Jadi we have a lot of founding father kita, ya. Jadi ada Kiai Hasyim Asy'ari, Kiai Haji Abdullah Hasan Hasbullah, and also Kiai Haji Ahmad Siddiq, ya. Is built is concept ukhuwah, ya. Ukhuwah Islamiyah and ukhuwah watonia between nation, yeah, and also ukhuwah between countries, the other countries, yeah, that is mean of ukhuwah watonia. And also the next is ukhuwah basaria, yeah, we can see in the Al-Qur'an surat Al-Hujurat, yeah, in ayah 13. A'udzubillahi minasyaitonirrajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ya ayyuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min dzakari wa unsa wa ja'alnakum su'uban wa qabaila lita'arofu. Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. Innallaha 'alimun khabir. Ya. Wahai manusia, sesungguhnya kami telah menciptakan kamu dari seorang laki-laki dan seorang perempuan, kemudian kami jadikan kamu berbangsa-bangsa dan bersuku-suku agar kamu saling mengenal, ta'aruf, ya. Sesungguhnya yang paling mulia di antara kamu di sisi Allah ialah orang-orang yang paling bertakwa. Sungguh Allah Maha mengetahui, Maha teliti. Ya. The ukhuwah basariyah is like we live in the world. Yeah, for example, now Indonesia is one of G20. Yeah, the 20 is that mean we are have part of the big economic country. Yeah, G20 is there are Turkey, Chinese, Russia, and also Russia. And also Japan, Korea, Australia, yeah, and Germany, and also and so there are a lot of the country. That mean is ukhuwah basariyah, yeah, ukhuwah between fellow human, yeah, antara bangsa, yeah, between a nation, yeah. This is very important in surat Al-Hujurat ayat 13 ini, ya, yeah, ayat 13. We call is a ukhuwah basariyah. So there are many tafsir from ukhuwah basariyah. Ya, dalam ayat ini dijelaskan bahwa Allah menciptakan manusia dari seorang laki-laki Adam dan seorang perempuan Hawa dan menjadikan berbangsa-bangsa, bersuku-suku, and also berbeda warna kulit bukan untuk saling mencompokkan, tetapi upaya saling mengenal dan menolong. Allah tidak menyukai orang-orang yang memperlihatkan kesombongan dengan keturunan, kepangkatan, kekayaan. Yang paling mulia di antara manusia bahwa di sisi Allah hanyalah orang-orang yang paling bertakwa. Ya, the best human is takwa, ya, kepada Allah. Jadi kebiasaan manusia memandang kemuliaan itu selalu dengan kebangsaan, kekayaan, padahal menurut pandangan Allah, orang yang paling mulia itu adalah orang-orang yang paling takwa kepadanya. Ya, so we can be Indonesia is a state is we can make correlation, ya, communication with the other country, and also in Ibnu Hibban dan At-Tirmidzi dari Ibnu Umar bahwa ia berkata Rasulullah Shallallahu Alaihi Wasallam ia melakukan tawaf di atas untanya yang telinganya tidak sempurna terputus sebagian pada hari Fath Makkah, ya, pembesaran Fath Makkah, dalam pembesaran Makkah. Lalu beliau menyentuh tiang Ka'bah dengan tongkat yang bengkok ujungnya. Beliau tidak mendapatkan tempat untuk menderumkan, ya, mengikat untanya di masjid sehingga unta itu dibawa keluar menuju lembah lalu menderumkannya di sana. Kemudian Rasulullah memuji Allah dan mengagungkannya. Kemudian berkata, wahai manusia, sesungguhnya Allah telah menghilangkan pada kalian keburukan perilaku jahiliyah. Wahai manusia, sesungguhnya manusia itu ada dua macam. Orang yang berbuat kebajikan, bertakwa, dan mulia di sisi Tuhannya. Dan orang-orang yang durhaka, celaka, dan hina di sisi Tuhannya. Kemudian Rasulullah membaca ayat. Ya ayuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min dzakarin wa unza. Beliau membaca sampai akhir ayat itu lalu berkata, inilah yang aku katakan dan aku memohon ampun kepada Allah untukku dan untuk kalian. Jadi ini Nabi Muhammad itu berusaha untuk meminta ampun, ya, untuk kita semuanya ini. Ini adalah sesuatu yang apa? Kita lihat bahwa Rasulullah itu mencontohkan ukhuwah basariyah, ya. Artinya apa? Bersaudara, brotherhood from the human. We don't care about the religion, we don't care about the nation. Ya, we call ukhuwah basariyah. Ya. And also in the Al-Qur'an surah Al-Isra ayat 17, the meaning is dan sungguh kami telah memuliakan anak cucu Adam dan kami angkut mereka di darat dan di laut dan kami beri mereka rezeki dari yang baik-baik dan kami lebihkan mereka di atas banyak makhluk yang kami ciptakan dengan kelebihan yang sempurna. Ya, ini maknanya adalah bahwa Bani Adam itu manusia, ya, the human, ya, yang and also malaikat, angel, and the jin, and also teufel, ya, semua jenis hewan dan tumbuhan from the kelebihan manusia dari makhluk-makhluk yang lain, fisik maupun non-fisik, sebagai firman Allah, sungguh kami telah menciptakan manusia, ya, dalam bentuk yang sebaik-baiknya. Jadi, so that is very important that we are is the best makhluk in the world. Ya, oleh sebab itu, we should always, ya, the connection, the communication with the other people, the other ethnic group, the other country, we call the ukhuwah basariyah, and also from the minister of religion Al-Isra, ya, selain diberi panca indera yang sempurna, manusia juga diberi hati, ya, our heart, ya, is a function of balancing, ya, to deciding, ya, jadi menimbang untuk membuat keputusan. Dan Allah mengeluarkan kamu dari perut ibumu dalam keadaan tidak mengetahui sesuatu pun. Dia memberimu pendengaran, penglihatan, hati nurani agar kamu bersyukur. Ya, so if we see in our life, we grow up in our mother, ya, in our mother at a fetus from 9 months, ya, before we can hear, we can see, we can have adjustment, a better, good, ya, yeah, and also kita akan selalu bersyukur, gitu ya. Kemudian manusia sebagai khalifah di muka bumi ini, firman Allah, dan ingatlah ketika Tuhanmu berfirman kepada malaikat, aku hendak menjadikan khalifah di bumi. Mereka berkata, apakah engkau hendak menjadikan orang yang merusak dan menumpahkan darah di sana, sedangkan kami bertasbih memujimu dan mensucikan namamu. Dia berfirman, sungguh aku mengetahui apa yang tidak kamu ketahui. So the very, very important thing that we should care about our world. Yeah. Now, for example, via is Khalifa. Yeah, this meaning we should take care the our world from and also the benefit of ukwa, yeah, get the sweet and delicious taste of faith, yeah, sebagaimana jadi keuntungannya ini ya, keuntungan daripada ukwa ini ya, Rasulullah, yeah, get the sweet and delicious taste of faith, yeah. And also Allah will protect and shelter him one day in judgment. Jadi kalau kita with the ukhuwah, with the silaturahmi, ya Allah will protect and shelter him, ya under shelter us one day of the judgment. Ya kita nanti akan dimasukkan ke dalam surganya Allah, gitu ya. Jadi kalau ini yang pertama, get the sweet of delicious taste of faith, bagaimana ya as Rasulullah say. Tiga perkara yang barang siapa mendapatinya, dia akan merasakan manisnya iman, yaitu dia love, ya, mencintai Allah and Prophet, ya, more than love in brother, ya, dia mencintai saudaranya dan dia tidaklah mencintai melainkan karena Allah. That we love our brother based on Allah, gitu ya, membenci kembali jadi apa namanya yang terpenting. Kemudian yang kedua, Allah will protect shelter him on the day of judgment. Ya, yeah. And we shall see the important is tujuh golongan yang mendapatkan naungan Allah pada hari yang tidak ada naungan kecuali naungannya. Di antaranya adalah dua orang yang saling mencintai karena Allah. Ya, yeah. We love each other, ya, yeah, based on Allah. Ya, depend on Allah. Juga sebagaimana disabdakan Rasulullah, sesungguhnya Allah berfirman pada hari kiamat, di manakah orang-orang yang saling mencintai karena kemuliaanku, pada hari ini aku akan menaungi mereka pada suatu hari yang tiada naungan kecuali naunganku. Ya. And also the benefit of ukwa bring a strong faith, ya, that will take him to heaven. Ya, we think us to heaven, ya, kalian akan masuk surga sampai kalian beriman, dan kalian belum dikatakan beriman sampai kalian saling mencintai, ya, maukah aku tunjukkan kepada kalian suatu perbuatan yang jika kalian lakukan akan membuat saling mencintai, tebarkan salam di antara kalian, ya, oleh sebab itu the important is assalamualaikum, ya, also but if we go to the broad in Germany we can say guten morgen, ya, good morning, good dag, gitu ya. Kalau kita di Belanda, ya, and also the other country, ya, konnichiwa kalau kita di Jepang dan sebagainya, ya. And of ukwa will produce noble character. Jadi kalau dengan ukwa ini kita menjadi yang rendah hati, ya, noble character. Kita akhlak yang mulia, ya, noble karakter. Di antaranya adalah sikap ramah, cinta kasih, peduli kebutuhan saudara seiman, sebangsa, sesama manusia sehingga kehidupannya aman. So I have also experience as I study in Germany, for example. Normally in December they have all a special occasion, ya, yeah, in December. And the Christmas normally. So normally I explain about Indonesia. Of course, it's in Germany. So we have close. Yeah, we can communicate it with each other, not only in the Muslim but also from the other's religion. Yeah, ukhuwah will strengthen the strength of the Muslim, the integrity of nation, and the peace of between human. Jadi kalau kita lihat, ukhuwah akan memperkokoh kekuatan kaum Muslimin, keutuhan suatu bangsa, dan kedamaian antara manusia. So we can see here in our country, we can live together. There are many religion in our country, but we can stay each other, we can love each other. And also the benefit of ukhuwah, yeah, is a summary, so we can a sweet of iman, yeah, and also we can protect it from from hari kiamat, yeah, in the last day, and also we have noble, and also we go to the heaven, yeah, and also memperkokoh keutuhan. It's building, it's our nation. Ya, jadi keuntungannya dari ukhuwah itu adalah seperti itu. Itu ya, kita bisa mengantarkan kita ke surga. Makanya oleh sebab itu the important thing we can communicate each other ya very well. So the implementation of ukhuwah ya surat At-Taubah ayat 71 dan orang-orang yang beriman laki-laki dan perempuan sebagian mereka menjadi penolong bagi sebagian yang lain. Mereka menyuruh berbuat yang ma'ruf dan mencegah yang mungkar, melaksanakan sholat, menunaikan zakat, dan taat kepada Rasul, yang mereka akan diberi rahmat oleh Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Sungguh Allah Maha Perkasa dan Maha Bijaksana. And also the implementation of ukhuwah, Rasulullah bersabda, janganlah kalian saling hasad, saling najasi, ya, menawar barang dengan harga yang lebih tinggi, tanpa bermaksud membeli, akan tetapi untuk memperdaya pihak lain. Saling membenci, saling acuh tak acuh. Ya, dari important is we respect each other. I already discussed before. Ya. Jadilah hamba Allah yang bersaudara. Seorang Muslim adalah saudara bagi Muslim yang lain. Oleh karena itu, janganlah menzalimi, menghina, mendustai, dan jangan pula meremehkan. Takwa itu ada di hati. Ya. Takwa is at least in our heart. Ya, and Allah Rasulullah say in the our grace is three times. Ya, cukuplah seorang dianggap memandang hina kepada saudaranya sama Muslim. Ya, setiap Muslim atas Muslim lain adalah haram, tidak boleh disentuh, diganggu darahnya, harta dan kehormatannya. Ya, every Muslim is our brother. His brotherhood is very important. Ya, and also the implementation of ukhuwah is like from hadis from Rasulullah dari Abu Hamzah Anas bin Malik radhiyallahu anhu, pembantu Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, dari Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam bersabda, salah seorang di antara kalian tidaklah beriman dengan iman sempurna sampai ia mencintai saudaranya sebagaimana ia mencintai dirinya sendiri. Ya, jadi he love his brothers like him, ya, like her, gitu ya. Dan ini ada juga, ya, barang siapa ingin dijauhkan dari neraka dan masuk ke dalam surga, hendaklah ketika ia mati dalam keadaan beriman kepada Allah, dan hendaklah dia berperilaku kepada orang lain sebagaimana dia senang diperlakukan orang lain. Ini hadis riwayat Muslim sebagaimana tadi, ya. Jadi the important implementation of ukhuwah, so we should be not tidak ya ria, ujub, ya hasad, angry, anania, egois, ya gibah, and namimah. This is forbidden here, ya forbidden here, ya in the sake of our heart, ya. So we should change with tawadu, ridho, syukur, sabar, kasih, sayang, peduli, and also always explain the good thing of our friend, and also peaceful, ya. Dan here is very important, ya. Ukhuwah between us ya, in religion ukwa Watonia and ukwa Basaria ya, ukwa between human. Ini yang penting ya, this important we are ukwa not only from the Muslim but also ukwa in the our country and also ukwa in Basaria in the world ya. Demikian kira-kira yang bisa saya sampaikan ya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Ya. Okay, if you have any question, don't hesitate to ask me.
Okay, so that's the lecture from Professor Agus Rubianto. Yeah. Thank you for your very good presentation and explanation. May all of us get the value and benefits from the lecture. For everyone during the meeting, if you want to give some questions, please raise your hand, unmute your microphone, or just text it on Zoom chat. Okay, maybe Hamas Robani can unmute your microphone and ask the question.
Menggunakan bahasa Indonesia enggak apa-apa, Mbak?
Enggak apa-apa, Mas. Silakan aja, Mas.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Iya, Waalaikumsalam.
Perkenalkan, nama saya Hamas Rabbani dari Departemen Teknik Mesin.
Ya.
Joint Degree. Pak, saya ingin bertanya. Kan di Indonesia itu ada banyak golongan-golongan, Pak, kayak Muhammadiyah, NU dan lain-lain. Nah, itu bagaimana apa ya? Biar kita kan ini kan ukhuwah kan, Pak?
Ya, ya.
Bagaimana menyikapinya atau bagaimana cara kita untuk tetap masih tetap bersatu gitu ya. Pak, terima kasih.
Oke, okay. Ya.
Warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oke, okay, thank you Mas Hamas. It's very is a good question ya. Yeah. We have we can see in Indonesia concerning the ukwa. We are also ukwa in same religions, ya. Yeah. Jadi kalau if you see that we don't care about is there are the people is in Nahdlatul Ulama or in Muhammadiyah or in the other group. Yeah, we are is one family. We are is brotherhood. Yeah, among Muslim will foster to deep sense of affection. Jadi kita harus apa namanya meningkatkan kasih sayang. Ya, yeah, jadi di antara Muslim itu tidak ada kita adalah saudara. Ya, I have experience in as I study in Germany. Ya, every people in the other world, for example, our brother from Afghanistan, our brother from Syria, and also our brother from Bosnia, they want to learn. Ya, Indonesia is a forebild. Ya, is the good example. Yeah, between us is live in harmony. Yeah, you see, Afghanistan is 90% is Muslim, but you can see they attack each others. Yeah, mereka berantem itu berlama-lama sekali. Jadi kita ini bersyukur, kita ini punya filosofi Pancasila. As I meet the diplomat from Africa, mereka sangat kagum. What is the meaning of Pancasila? Gitu. So you can see that via good philosophy, Pancasila is come from the Piagam Madinah. Yeah, it's developed from Piagam Madinia. So in our country we have Pancasila. Jadi kalau kita itu harus menghargai satu sama yang lainnya. Ya, dan ingat bahwa apa namanya? Rasulullah itu mengajarkan kita itu beragama itu yang wasatiyah, ya, yang di tengah-tengah. Kita ingat. Kenapa negara kita ini demikian apa? Mungkin kalau kita lihat, makanya kalau saya bahasa Indonesia aja buat semuanya ya. Jangan sering membaca hoax ya. Anda perlu keluar negeri. Sehingga Anda bisa tahu betapa hebatnya kita. Saudara-saudara kita itu dari Egypt itu belajar tentang pemerintahan di sini. Ya. Dan kemarin saya ke Turki itu ya. Ini sebentar saya tunjukkan ini. Di Turki itu apa namanya? Mazhabnya Hanafi ya. Kita itu mazhabnya Syafi'i. Ya. Tapi kalau Anda ke sana itu, kalau sholat ya, itu aminnya itu pelan kalau di sana itu. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim gitu. Amin gitu. Karena mazhabnya Hanafi. Karena kita Indonesia, saya pakai kopiah seperti ini, saya amin gitu ya. Mereka lihat semua. Tapi dia paham, oh itu saudara saya gitu ya. Karena dia merasa bahwa orang apa namanya Indonesia is our brother gitu ya, walaupun beda. Dan apa namanya mereka juga sama seperti kita itu setelah sholat itu berzikir gitu ya, sama-sama. Ini apa namanya saya ngomong yang apa tadi kita bicara mengenai ukhuwah Islamiyah, we call ukhuwah Basariyah ya, and also apa namanya Basariyah ini kalau Turki ini mix ya between Islamiyah and Basariyah gitu. Demikian Mas. Jadi kita makanya satu kelebihan kita itu ya, orang Indonesia itu murah senyum. Ya. Senyum is sedekah. Itu penting itu. Saya pengalaman saya sekolah, saya di 12 tahun di Jerman itu, orang Jerman itu enggak pernah senyum. Kalau saya ketemu ya saya jawab Guten Morgen. Kalau ada orang Jerman banyak, Guten Morgen zusammen gitu kan. Walaupun saya pakai kopiah begitu, mereka ini orang mana gitu. Kok ramah sekali gitu, kok friendly. Bahkan ya because I'm study in Germany, so some German people ask me, "Where are you come from?" "I come from Indonesia. What do you study in Germany?" I say, "I study physics." "Hey, Albert Einstein out from Indonesia," gitu. Karena kita, ya, saya dipanggil Albert Einstein. "Hi, Albert Einstein from Indonesia. Come together, we drink coffee." Gitu ya. Jadi ini, apa namanya itu, kita ini luar biasa, Mas. Jadi Mas Hamas Rabbani, ya saya doakan mudah-mudahan nanti bisa juga ke Germany ya, karena double degree.
Amin.
Double degree-nya mesin kan, mechanical engineering with Germany kan? With Wismar,
yes.
Mas ya?
Ya, yeah, Wismar, Pak.
Ya, yeah, I was twice in Wismar University, Mas. So, if you go to the Wismar, don't forget to go to the Warmenmunde Beach. It's very beautiful. You can eat delicious fish in Lichten restaurant. Ya, lupa. Gitu, Mas. Mas, terima kasih pertanyaannya. Bagus. Good question.
Terima kasih, Pak.
So, sambil anu ya, saya carikan perjalanan saya ke Turki, nanti saya tunjukkan ini. Okay, please if you have any question, don't forget to ask me, don't hesitate to ask, yeah. So I try to look for our journey to the Turkey, yeah, and to see our brotherhood in Turkey, yeah. Okay. Yeah, is one of the minister of in the Turkey with us in our pavilion, in ITS pavilion. We saw our, he is Professor Ibrahim, he is the president of the defense industrial in Turkey. They go to our, and also here is the vice president, and also the from vice president, they come to our, they ask about concerning about RET, about, and also I can see here, look, the character of, the beautiful, and also here, and also in the, in the Turkey, Hagia Sophia, the first year is the church, and also changed as a mosque, and now is as museum, and now is as mosque again. So, and I see from this region is a holy place from the Christian. Di sini ini di tengah-tengah Masjid Hagia Sophia itu ada tempat. Ini tidak boleh untuk sholat. Di daerah sini itu. Kalau ada sholat, ini karena ini adalah tempat sucinya orang Kristen. Walaupun di Hagia Sophia itu menjadi apa namanya di masjid, tapi sholatnya ini dipakai untuk apa, khusus ini untuk orang Kristen. Gitu ya. Dan juga kita lihat di sini ya, bagaimana di sana itu menghargai pahlawan ya. Sultan Al-Fatih yang menaklukkan Konstantinopel itu, ini ada makamnya. Ini ada delegasi dari apa namanya? Dari Indonesia, Yai Ma'ruf Qosim dari PBNU Jawa Timur, ini apa namanya itu berzikir ya, mendoakan Sultan Al-Fatih di sini. Tapi bagaimana dengan orang Turki? Sama saja. Ini ketika kita berdoa ini ada orang Turki ya, apa istilahnya itu, anaknya ulama dari Turki di sini juga ikut berdoa bersama. Ketika duduk, yang dari ini yang pakai jaket ini adalah anak ulama termasyhur yang ada di Turki. Ya, jadi doa dan tahlil itu juga sama di Turki, itu sama seperti itu. Kemudian juga ini di makamnya ya, Abu Ayyub Al-Ansari, sahabat Rasulullah, yang apa dimakamkan di dalam bentengnya. Ketika dia menaklukkan itu, maka meninggal dalam peperangan. Maka berpesan dikubur di bawah benteng. Jadi ini adalah makam daripada sahabat Abu Ayyub Al-Ansari. Ya, ini kita kira seperti ini sekedar untuk sharing ya, bahwa ukhuwah ukhuwah Islamiyah, ukhuwah Watoniyah, dan ukhuwah Basariyah. Jadi ini yang harus diperhatikan ya. Oleh sebab itu, kalau pengalaman saya, if I experience is I meet, for example, our brother from Bosnia, so they think that Muslim is from Europe. If you see our face, they look Shang-Chi gitu ya. Kita itu dipikir ahli kungfu gitu. Jadi kalau saudara kita Bosnia itu seolah-olah orang Muslim itu Eropa. Dia nggak tahu kalau bahwa kita ini dianggap orang Cina gitu ya. Ketika saya sholat di masjidnya itu, dia bikin kungfu kayak kita gitu. Ya saya bisa, saya bisa karate ya. Saya action saja kayak gitu. Gitu ya, Mas Rahmat. Okay, Mbak Yasmin, please go ahead, Mbak Yasmin, if you have any question, Mbak.
Thank you for the chance, sir. So yeah. I was going to ask something maybe more to your experience abroad. Do you have perhaps any suggestion on how to increase our tolerance with cultural difference so that we can establish ukhuwah basyariyah easily?
I have an experience, Mbak Yasmin, as I was a student and also I was a diplomat in Indonesian embassy. As I was student, I live in the region, yeah, where the people, most of the people is Catholic, yeah, most of the people Catholic, and also my Lord Lady is also Catholic. So, but normally there are have like for example in the Christmas time, yeah, you see that we have also like meeting, yeah. So I always go to the meeting, but I don't go to the church, but I go to the meeting, eat together. Normally they cook special for us because I'm Muslim. They cook like vegetarian, yeah. So and also I bring from our home like a cake, is halal cake. We can eat together. Yeah, the important thing we should say that I cannot eat pig, for example, yeah, and I cannot I don't drink alcohol. They understand of us. And also, if you go, for example, if you want to pray in our room, yeah, misalkan kita mau, yeah, you should ask my friend, excuse me, I want to pray here, yeah, yeah. Could you apa? Don't you mind if I pray here? Gitu ya. Biasanya kalau saya apa namanya? Kalau saya biasanya pakai bahasa Jerman ya. Darf ich hier beten? Gitu ya. Bolehkah saya sholat di sini? Jadi ngomong dulu, Mbak. Jadi kalau saya dulu saya punya satu ruangan itu kan biasanya kalau orang mereka kan risih kan. Ini orang tiap hari kok menghadap ke Mekah 5 kali gitu. Tapi kalau Anda sudah terbiasa, dia langsung menulis apa namanya. Makanya waktu saya apa namanya selesai program sekolah saya itu, mereka menulis kisah saya. Ada anak dari negara berkembang jauh, nggak pernah lihat salju, tetapi tiap hari dia menghadap ke Mekah 5 kali, gitu kan. Bahkan yang menarik itu in the fasting month, ya, in the Ramadan. My friend always ask me, do you finish with your fasting? Jadi puasa itu ditunggu karena saya tidak pernah gabung dengan mereka untuk ngafi dan sebagainya, gitu ya. Saking apa we call we ukhuwah basaria. I have friend from Indian, I have from Spanish, yeah, Spain. I have friend from Tunisian. I have from Sudan, from Afghanistan. So there are many several nations in my university. But however, we still consistent with our religions. Yeah. Tapi yang terpenting adalah kita harus mohon dulu, ya, meminta izin dulu. Jadi kalau mau sholat gitu, kadangkala mereka itu kalau kita mereka mereka mesti akan mengizinkan, nggak mungkin, karena kita mau menghadap Tuhan. Kalau misalkan dia menolak gitu, saya mengatakan, I want to pray for my God. Why do you forbid it to me? Why do you stop me? Mereka mikir-mikir, oh iya ya, ini orang yang sangat apa namanya itu patuh pada agamanya gitu. Kadangkala saya dikatakan ini. Somehow ya yeah, our I call my Lord Lady Matilda Niewuhrmer is say that the Islam Indonesia is better than the other Islam sampai segitu. Islam Indonesia ini luar biasa ya. Karena for example my wife ya yeah, is also take hijab, but my wife always help ya. Yeah. German people, gitu ya. Jadi yang terpenting itu kita tunjukkan bahwa Muslim itu adalah bisa open minded, gitu ya. Kadangkala kami yang Muslim ini, ya mohon maaf ini saya bukan menjelekkan yang lainnya, gitu ya. Ada dari negara lain gitu, dia membandingkan itu. Ternyata Islammu itu, Islam Indonesiamu itu bagus sekali ya. dibandingkan dengan yang mereka-mereka itu. Karena mereka tidak bergaul, ya, menutup diri. Kalau saya sendiri, saya selalu terbuka. Karena di apa kita itu, di Indonesia itu, Islam ya atau Rasulullah mengajarkan kita di fasatiyah, ya, di tengah-tengah kita itu. Tidak ke kanan, tidak ke kiri, kita di tengah. Tetapi tetap Al-Quran dan Hadis sebagai pedomannya. Gitu ya. The guide outline is Al-Quran and Hadis. And also we are very proud of our country. Ya, we live united in diversity. Itu Mbak Yasmin. Thanks for your question, Mbak. Oke, okay, Mas Brian.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
I have a question, but my question is out of topic. But yeah, this is often debated by Indonesian people. My question is, I saw in the Sultan Al-Fatih's tomb or makam Sultan Al-Fatih, that is a fence atau diberi kijing, di pagar.
Yeah.
Padahal in Islam we are forbidden to fence the tomb atau mengkijing makam. What do you think about that, sir?
Itulah ilak sampean itu. Itu ndak, itu ada apa? Itu banyak sekali. Makanya saya katakan itu ya, if you read, you should see in the other speech, ya. Anda mengatakan bahwa itu dilarang. Enggak, ini buktinya ini. Ini apa namanya yang di Turki dia menghargai kok. Ya. Ya ini saya tunjukkan nih. Jadi anu Mas, jangan apa namanya kalau anu itu belajar yang lam ini. Ini sahabat makamnya sahabat Al-Ansari aja dibagusin kayak begini. Apalagi Sultan Al-Fatih. Ya. Setelah meresmikan apa namanya itu Hagia Sophia itu sebagai masjid, Presiden Erdogan itu ke sini berdoa di Sultan Al-Fatih. Dan Presiden Erdogan juga membersihkan makamnya Al-Fatih dan dibuat seperti ini. Gitu, Mas Brian. Makanya Mas Brian ini harus belajar ke Jawa Timur, penting itu. Jadi Anda harus apa ke makam-makam para wali yang ada di Jawa Timur itu biar tahu, Mas. Ya. Jadi apa namanya? Berpikirlah yang tadi yang saya katakan itu ya, bahwa ukhuwah wasatiyah, ya, ukhuwah Islamiyah and ukhuwah Watoniyah and Basariyah. Jadi di sini di Turki mana buktinya dilarang, ya? Tahu nggak, Mas? Nih saya tunjukkan ini Sultan Fatih yang sampean puja-puja ini. Nih, Mas. Nih ya. Sultan Al-Fatih, kebahagiaan saya bukan keberhasilan menaklukkan Konstantinopel, tetapi kebahagiaan saya karena keberadaan lelaki di masa saya. Jadi Sultan Al-Fatih itu di gurunya ini guru torekot, Mas. Jadi beliau sejak kecil itu diajari berpikir, ya, memahami spiritualnya ini. Ini yang kalau Anda ke sana, nanti kalau ketemu ke sana, cari guru orang Turki yang keturunannya dari Al-Fatih, gitu ya. Dan apa namanya, nanti akan beliau akan menjelaskan. Jadi Sultan Al-Fatih itu, ya, ini supaya ini meluruskan ini. Kalau membaca YouTube itu, tapi cari apa namanya ke tempat guru spiritual yang apa namanya yang punya wawasan yang luas, ya, bahwa Sultan Al-Fatih itu ya memiliki guru spiritualnya dari Sam. Nah, ini jadi sejak kecil itu memang diajari tarekat, sampai setelah dia menaklukkan itu dia kepingin tidak jadi raja, tetapi oleh gurunya tidak. Kamu Al-Fatih tetap harus jadi sultan karena negara Turki ini membutuhkan kamu agar negara ini jadi stabil, gitu, Mas. Ya, ini kalau misalkan sampai dilarang ini dianjurkan sama Presiden Erdogan, buktinya tidak. Gitu, Mas, ya. Mas Brian. Ini supaya Mas Brian itu anu, makanya apa namanya berjalan ke ke Turki, nanti Anda ke beberapa makam-makam yang ada di sana, ada ziarah, dan juga orang Turki ziarah di sini juga. Jangan dibilang tidak. Mereka berziarah di sini. Jadi, apa namanya, ini kebetulan kalau makam Sultan Al-Fatih ini ada di Istanbul. Jadi Anda bisa naik metro, naik apa, bisa ke sini. Gitu, Mas. Terima kasih, Mas Brian. Pertanyaannya bagus sekali.
All right, sir. Thank you for your explanation.
Ya. There are many, banyak perbedaan ya. Kalau saya melihat Indonesia sama Turki hampir banyak kesamaannya. Mereka menghargai para ulama. Jadi makam-makam ulama di sana itu dirawat. Dan juga saudara-saudara kita Turki itu banyak yang berziarah. Ya, mendoakan di situ gitu ya. Dan jangan sangat menghormati ulama, sangat menghormati, termasuk Presiden Erdogan. Ya, setelah beliau meresmikan tadi, ini yang saya terangkan pakai bahasa Indonesia aja ya. Ini apa? Saya bersyukur kemarin pas ke sana itu bisa sholat di Hagia Sophia ini. Ini Hagia Sophia ini ceritanya dulu kan gereja nih, tapi dulunya itu kuil, Mas. Ya, jadi ingat jangan sampai salah. Pertama itu adalah kuil. Sebelum ada Kristen itu dia kuil. Lalu jadi gereja, lalu ditaklukkan, jadi masjid. Kemudian setelah itu jadi museum, dan sekarang jadi masjid. Nah, setelah Presiden Erdogan itu sholat di sini, beliau langsung ke makam Sultan Al-Fatih ya, dan berdoa di sini. Itu gitu kisah-kisahnya ya, ini supaya apa namanya, tapi di Istanbul itu memang ini Hagia Sophia ya, di berhadapan dengan Sultan Ahmed. Jadi ada dua masjid ini, yang pertama dari Konstantinopel, kemudian dibangunlah waktu Sultan Al-Fatih itu sebuah masjid di depannya gitu ya. Nah, kalau ini zamannya Konstantinopel, ini Galatasaray Tower yang menjadi apa, simbolnya sepak bola Galatasaray. Demikian kira-kira. Silakan. If you have any question, silakan. Nanti saya tambahkan.
Okay. If there is no question, I think this is the end of the meeting today. Okay, well, ladies and gentlemen, finally we come to the end of this event. To close this event, let's recite doa kafaratul majlis.
Subhanakallah
wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka.
Thank you very much for your coming and your nice attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yes, sir.
Oke, Mbak Sasa Bila, thank you ya Mbak ya.
Ya, yeah, thank you juga, Prof.
Ya, saya aju izin dulu ya, leave ya.
Ya, yeah, Prof, terima kasih.
Bisa dijawab terlebih dahulu.
Oke, siap. Terima kasih.
Boleh di end all minutes.
Ya, Safia.
Ya, Prof, terima kasih.
Ya, nggak apa-apa.